January 30, 2018. The Dilemma of Obedience. Samuel was afraid to tell Eli the vision. 1 Samuel 3:15. God never speaks to us in dramatic ways, but in ways that are easy to misunderstand. Then we say, I wonder if that is God's voice. Isaiah said that the Lord spoke to him with a strong hand, that is, by the pressure of his circumstances, Isaiah 8:11. Without the sovereign hand of God himself, nothing touches our lives. Do we discern his hand at work, or do we see things as mere occurrences? Get into the habit of saying, "Speak, Lord," and life will become a romance. 1 Samuel 3:9. Every time circumstances press in on you, say, "Speak, Lord," and make time to listen. Chastening is more than a means of discipline. It is meant to bring me to the point of saying, "Speak, Lord." Think back to a time when God spoke to you. Do you remember what he said? Was it Luke 11:13, or was it 1 Thessalonians 5:23? As we listen, our ears become more sensitive, and like Jesus, we will hear God all the time. Should I tell my Eli what God has shown to me? This is where the dilemma of obedience hits us. We disobey God by becoming amateur providences and thinking, I must shield Eli, who represents the best people we know. God did not tell Samuel to tell Eli he had to decide that for himself. God's message to you may hurt your Eli, but trying to prevent suffering in another's life will prove to be an obstruction between your soul and God. It is at your own risk that you prevent someone's right hand being cut off or right eye being plucked out. See Matthew 5:29-30. Never ask another person's advice about anything God makes you decide before him. If you ask advice, you will almost always side with Satan. I did not immediately confer with flesh and blood, Galatians 1:16.